I don't try to psychologize things very much. We were taught to do that in the 50s and the 60s, 70s. It was all about psychology. Psychology was king. And everything was psychologized. It's unbelievable how much we did that. Now I don't do that at all. I come at the situation from a completely different angle. The gurus often talk about how it's puzzling. Why do we act the way we do? It's so easy. Why it's so puzzling? Why don't we just, you know, be enlightened? What I do is I look at the puzzlement and say, why are we puzzled, etc. And what I say is that we are trying to teach ourselves a lesson, a great lesson, which we cannot teach ourselves it. So all of this time, all this craziness, all this stuff we're doing, it's very purposeful, actually. It's not crazy. It's not anything other than very purposeful, except the purpose can never be realized, which is to teach ourselves how to abide in total mental chaos so that then we can experience what it's like to be Prime Creator. That is why this whole, all of this dance of Maya arises. It's to teach us. We're trying to learn something. So you look at it that way, it changes the whole scope of everything entirely. No more need to psychologize anything, to worry about any of that. It's just simply, everything's on a different basis now, a simpler basis. And we just say, the lessons of time are not needed. I don't need the lessons of time at all. I don't need to learn anything from this imaginary past. All these lessons we're generating are really an imagined past, something, effects that are taking place prior to a real effect taking place. In other words, past effects, but not effects right now. So that's why I dispense with all the rest of that other stuff. And I feel that once this is seen, and this becomes more of a way of viewing our situation, enlightenment will become much, much, much easier. Much, much easier. It's on a much more solid foundation and looking at it this way. It's just difficult to get there because it hasn't really been looked at this way in the past for some reason. I don't know why. But it certainly hasn't. Now, in the 60s and the 70s, we were completely enmeshed in psychologizing everything. And that's like a previous life to me now. I can't hardly even remember what it was like. But faintly, I know that it was just unbelievable how much we would do that. So naturally, any teaching at that time had to have psychology as its root. Otherwise, we wouldn't have paid any attention to it. We were completely wrapped up in that. And so the various teachings that came out of that time, like A Course in Miracles, was heavily used a lot of psychology and based on psychology and stuff. But interesting enough, by focusing on that, I gradually left all that behind, completely behind, and I see no real importance to it whatsoever anymore. And now I've gone to declarations of, I am divine, I don't need the lessons of time. I am divine, I have no commitment to time. See? I am divine, I have no commitment to time. It's important to focus on, I don't need the lessons of time. And that covers it all. That covers it all. If we can get to that state of looking at it this way, that we're trying to teach ourselves something. All this dying and misery and relationships and suffering, everything that's going on, whether you want to psychologize it or not, is simply we're trying to teach ourselves something, and the lesson is so impossible. We break it up into little pieces and we try to do it a step at a time, step at a time, step at a time, step at a time. And that's why you go through all these lives, all these situations. We're continuously teaching ourselves a little bit of destabilization, and then a little more destabilization, and then more destabilization. We keep going through situations of destabilization. For instance, like we're well for a while, and then we get sick. That's destabilization. And we say, oh my gosh, I was feeling so stable, and now I'm just like can't function at all. This is terrible. That's destabilization. And keep in mind that in order to experience destabilization, you have to first be in a semi-stable state in order to have a contrast and make it seem like it's a learning situation. So we do have these semi-stable states we call life. What we call life are just semi-stable states of mind and actually of imagination that's being that mind is conjuring up, and then we have breakdowns of the of these semi-stable states. We call it destabilizing, whether it's a sickness or whether it's a loss of some type or confusion or a threat or a death or all these different types of displacements and destabilizations. And then this registers like, oh, this is a lesson. This is something I need to get used to. I need to integrate this. I need to, this is a lesson that I need to learn. So that is what we go through in existence, what we call life. It's not really life. It's just a training exercise that we've set up. We've set up this training ground for training exercises, and that's all we're doing. And ultimately, what we're trying to do is to abide in total mental chaos, which is impossible. So all these lessons that we're doing incrementally, gradual destabilization, it's all futile. It gets us nowhere, actually. Absolutely nowhere. And the sooner we realize this, the better off we are. We don't keep on doing it. We say, whoa, wait a minute, this is never going to work. So why don't I just stop? Let me choose a different idea. Let me choose not to be prime creator. Let me not try to be prime creator. Let me not try to change reality. Therefore, I don't need to learn any lessons of how to abide in total mental chaos, because that effect won't arise at all. And let me experience bliss. Let me give a different purpose to all the staging that we've used for this training exercise. Remind myself that I was never here. I'm not affected. I've never been affected by any of these lessons. These lessons have no importance for me, etc., etc. So we can do that. But what's crucial is to view it in a new light, saying these are simply training exercises that we are putting ourselves through. Using a body, of course, a body can be destabilized. Spirit cannot be destabilized. So we imagine ourselves that we're these bodies in this world full of other bodies, where everything can be destabilized. And we go through all these terrible destabilizations. Seeing other people be destabilized is a very potent type of destabilization. Seeing the tragedy of others. So you see on the news now, all the news is such bad news, right? What is it? Destabilization. If you go through the news articles, go through every single one, you realize they're just talking about destabilization. And you read this news, you look at it, and you say, oh my gosh, how destabilizing, that's terrible. I know if it happened to them, it can happen to me. So collectively, the planet is now getting these intense, intense lessons of destabilization. And of course, there's more to come, more to come. It's accelerating, constantly accelerating the destabilization on this planet, because there's a big push to learn the lesson and really get it, because we're tired of this training exercise and we want to succeed. So of course there's going to be some big destabilizations. I've mentioned one probable destabilization to cope with the problems of global warming and atmospheric problems, etc. The planet is for a fairly large asteroid, I don't know, was it more than a kilometer, maybe a couple kilometers, coming down into the ocean somewhere up by Greenland or something like that, and putting a lot of water vapor up in the air, and then maybe another one coming down over land and creating a huge water vapor dust cloud in the atmosphere to cut out to block the heat and drop the heat of the planet, climate change basically. That's a destabilization type of thing. But there's constant destabilizations going on all the time in existence. Just look at the Google News, Yahoo News, whatever newspaper. Yeah, it is just unbelievable. And that's just a tiny little bit. It's just constantly, destabilization is constantly happening. So the fact is, we don't need any of that, okay, to be what we already are. We don't need any of it. So this type of looking at this way takes us completely out of psychologizing everything, which I find to be, I don't like it anymore at all. I feel much clearer and more centered and calm by looking at it this way than trying to psychologize everything. Like saying, well, how does that make you feel? Well, I feel, what you said kind of makes me feel a little bit this way, and I feel this and I feel that. And are you trying to project something on me, or I'm projecting on you? And da 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 da. Oh my God! At some point, I overdosed on that. Total overdose on that. And no more of that. It's not necessary. It's really not necessary. much, much simpler, easier way to look at the entire situation here. It's simply a training exercise we don't need, and we've never needed it, and we never will need it. And that's it. I am, and time isn't. Just dismiss the whole training exercise. I am divine. I don't need time. All right? I am perfection itself. I don't need training. Don't need any training to be what I am. I don't need any training to be what I am. I don't need to train myself in loss of what I am to become something different, because I can't become anything different. See, we're trying to train ourselves to cope with the loss of what we are so we can become something different. It's very simple. We have to experience the loss of what we are. In other words, be annihilated, and then somehow cope with that, and so we can become something different. In other words, prime creator. So we are trying to gradually, you know, train ourselves to get used to not to losing what we are, and so we can become something different than what we are. The great good news is we can't be anything different than what we are. So there's no reason to keep on trying to train ourselves to somehow cope with the loss of what we are. We can't lose what we are. We cannot lose what we are. It's impossible. So all this training is useless. Serves no purpose whatsoever. So the more we tell ourselves this and realize this is all we need to know, really. This is just about it. We say, wow, I can't change what I am. So I can't suffer any loss. So I don't need a training exercise to help me cope with suffering the loss of what I am. And for the sake of continuity, I can just give a different purpose for all this staging that I've used in this training exercises and have it reflect back to me that I don't need any of it, and that what I am is already perfect. I can be in bliss here, steady state, no training, no loss, no destabilization at all. So you can be in the world and suffer no feelings of destabilization at all, no matter what happens. So it's quite simple, actually. So I'm not really able to teach this in a psychologizing type of way. I know many people are still into that. I completely OD'd on that. Totally. No mas, you know. It's just, wow. That, got to find a better way. Got to find a better way. And, because the suffering, you have to account for it. You have to account for the destabilizations that are taking place all the time. You have to say, well, why? Why? It's not a puzzle. It's not a mystery. I said, no, it's not a mystery. We can explain exactly what's going on. And that's what it is. Is limiting loss, gradually trying to get used to. It's like trying to get into a scalding hot, boiling cauldron of oil. And we just get closer and closer and closer to the oil. Maybe we dip a finger in. Ah, we're shrieking, you know. Ah, I seared my finger. I mean, dip a hand in, you know. We're just trying to get used so eventually we can sit into that boiling cauldron of oil and say, ah, this is so nice. But we cannot. We try to jump into the hot tub of oil, and we'll jump out and go, ah, too hot in the hot tub. We can't stand it. Yeah, because I've done it. I did. I sat in the hot tub of total mental chaos, and I jumped out automatically. And you cannot rest in that. It's impossible. So all this stuff, we're trying to get used to this boiling cauldron of oil, is useless. It is absolutely useless. So it's very, very simple. When you see it this way, you say, well, why do we need to psychologize anything? We don't. Why? No need to. We simply don't need these training exercises at all. And then for the sake of continuity, we keep the staging, give a different purpose to it. Boom, that's it. So whatever happens, happens in the world. Whatever destabilization then happens, it happens. It's certainly going to happen. That when you have everybody intensely engaged in the training exercise and wanting to have the most intense destabilization so they can really make vast progress, you know that there's going to be destabilizations. The rug pulled out from under us in many different ways. And we've set ourselves up. We've set it up. We've set it up. Absolutely set it up. So somehow, after all these years, I've been able to pretty much shed all the psychologizing, which is an amazing thing, which is why I seem different. Because I just don't even bother to even talk about it really anymore. It doesn't fit anymore at all. But it was a real struggle, big struggle. Awful. I felt like trying to get out of quicksand. What we need is simply a seamless experience of bliss, of all the staging of existence reflecting back to us that we've never been in it. We've never been in this movie. We've never been affected by the movie. We'll never need this movie. We'll never need it. And we are exactly as we've always been, untouched by all of this. And we can give that purpose to the staging. Easy. Easy. So, when you get free of all the psychologizing of it, your mind is much quieter. It's not trying to interpret anything. Like, what did they mean by that? I can't even remember what it was like. It's like all the psychologizing, but. Now, when you said that, were you thinking of me and me and you are, you know, how what kind of relationship do we have? And did you see me this way or did I see that? Nah, nah, nah. Like, oh, there's no thoughts of any of that. There's no thoughts of me or you or anything like that. It's simply, what is the situation? What is existence? Why is existence arising? Why is there this situation of bodies and earth and this lives and all this stuff? What is this? It's just a training exercise. We don't need the training exercise. This training exercise, spirit doesn't need it. That's it. So it has zero application for spirit, none. So all we do is give it a different purpose. You know, that's it. So there's not a lot of other stuff going through my mind, really, other than dealing with the potholes of life, all these destabilizations which constantly happen. You plant your garden and the gophers show up, you know, of course. Interestingly, this year, the gophers showed up and a mole showed up, and the mole went all over the place, and the gopher showed up, but the gopher then has disappeared. I had a little mental talk with the gopher. I said, hey, you know, if you bother me this year, it might be trouble for you. And the gopher disappeared, hasn't shown up again, didn't do any damage. One little flower it got, but, so maybe the gopher doesn't like this garden anymore, you know, no psychologizing here. I find that psychologizing is a great way to delay, great way to delay. Who cares what people mean about something? It has no meaning whatsoever. Time has no meaning. I am and time isn't. There's no reason to try to find some meaning here. There is no meaning. It's futile. It's a waste of time. Time is a waste of time. As one of our great viewers has pointed out, time is a waste of time, absolutely. So there's no reason to try to find something in here, or talk about your loss, or you know, just dramatize it, romanticize it, emotionalize it, psychologize it. Existence is a zero, it's a nothing. Because its only purpose is to get us used to total mental chaos. Other than that, it has no purpose. So if that goal can't be reached, it has no purpose whatsoever. All this other stuff we think is having some purpose. It's not, it's just steps to try and get to a certain place. Of itself, it has no utility, zero purpose whatsoever. Just our day-to-day lives and everything we're doing. No meaning whatsoever, none. It's only attempting to teach us an ultimate lesson. And that ultimate lesson can never be learned. So this is truly a waste of time. Just a waste. Not doing anything, actually. We're literally not doing anything. Silence, there's no thoughts going on really, just kind of a waiting to say, okay, how's it? Let it settling in, let it settle in, that's all. Let it settle in. It feels fine. I just say, how's it feel? Feels fine. No problem at all. But I find all this psychologizing and icing and socializing, all stuff to be so unbelievably tedious and boring and just immediately just no, a complete waste of time. Nothing is taking place and just utter waste of time. Always want to get right to the issue. Hey, do we need time? Do we need lessons of time or not? Let's just ask that question immediately. Do we need the lessons of time or not? If we don't need them, then what are we doing? Why don't we exchange them for just for bliss? Happiness, perfect happiness without any lessons being learned. We don't need any lessons. But the world just doesn't get to this level of questioning, this level of looking at it this way. If you do, you just kind of be quiet and say, And nothing much else will arise, just, It's a very simple thing. Do I need the lessons of time or not? I don't. Lessons of time are not needed. Nobody needs them. For anything whatsoever. What happens? Still breathing. Everything's still breathing. Body's still functioning. that's no problem. The body keeps functioning. A car is still a car. You know, the driver might say, hey, I don't really need to drive this car all over the place, so I just park it here and relax. Car is still there, you know. The engine, you don't have to turn it off. The engine's still idling. Radio's still on. Air conditioner's still on. But you just sit parked there and just relaxed. Not driving anywhere, so to speak. So the car is still functional. Body's still functional. Body doesn't have any independent purpose of its own. Just like a car. So the body, just because you say time is complete, has no purpose, completely meaningless, lessons of time are totally unnecessary, it doesn't cause any reaction in the body. I've never experienced any reaction. There's like a deep nervous reaction affecting deeper levels or something. But as far as just the basic, you know, functioning of the body, no, never experienced any changes in that. Feel exactly the same. So what I've found is my patients with all the psychologizing and various types of izing, I don't have any more patience for it. So when I try to watch a video of someone who's doing that, I just can't stop. I can't do it. I can't watch it anymore. I said, no. No, this is a waste of time. I look at people who've done that, and like older people. I just watched a video of older people, and they said, oh, I went to see this guru, and I was in bliss, and they're like 85 years old, and they're still just the same as they've ever been. Still psychologizing things and thinking and conceptualizing all this kind of stuff. Still thinking, oh, I got a lesson. Time gave me a great lesson. I'm trying to figure out what that lesson was. You know, I experienced bliss. The guru's there, and then now this. How do I integrate it? You know, how it's like, and it's all this stuff is the same. They're not free at all. So, and seeing that, I just said, wow. You know, this isn't good. I don't want to be like that. And I'm perilously close to it, but working to get away from it, that is for sure. So sort of an aversion has grown to just avert that, avoid it. I don't need the lessons of time. I am divine. I don't need the lessons of time. Every one of us can say that because we are all divinely created. We don't need the lessons of time whatsoever. We don't need to try to learn how to get into that total state of total mental chaos and abide in it, like sitting in a vat of hot boiling oil. We don't need to try and learn how to do that because, one, we can never learn how to do that, and two, since it's impossible, why waste time? And three, it's terribly horrible to do this. We're not happy. We're frightened. Say what you want, we're all frightened. And so it's no fun. It's no fun. Who wants to do this? Nobody wants to really do this. And we don't need to do it at all. Absolutely don't need to do it. But I see that people approach the spiritual path like they're trying to learn something. That's not it. You're trying to recognize you don't need to learn anything. So you can say, I don't know anything. I don't need to know anything. I don't need to know anything. I don't need to learn anything. This is more appropriate. I don't need to go through any training whatsoever. Completely useless for me. It's like when you experience the self, the true self, you say, oh my God, how can I teach that anything? I can't teach that self anything. It's perfect. So, oh, I can't, that's not myself. I don't want that self. I need a self I can teach. So where's the human self? We look for it, you know, out there. Oh, I found the human self now. I can teach the human self. It's very teachable. It's, look at all the problems it has. So we're scared about ourself because it doesn't need any teaching. It's flawless. It's perfect. It doesn't have any past at all. Could never have any past. Doesn't need to learn how to get used to being something that it's not. You see? So we're afraid of certitude of the self. We are frightened of it because we think, oh, how can we teach certitude? You know, if we have perfect certitude, there's nothing to teach. We think, no, we have lessons we gotta learn. We gotta have a lot of teaching needs to take place. So we're looking for the teacher. Where's the teacher? Who's gonna teach us? Now, the guru doesn't teach you anything. It just reassures you don't need to be taught anything. Don't need the lessons of time. So we know we're in a very unstable situation now in the world. We realize that. There's no way to deny it. The acceleration of everything on this planet the using up of resources. You have 7 billion people, a lot of those people in third world, underdeveloped countries who are now becoming developed very quickly. And the strain on the planet, you know, is simply, you know, off the charts completely. So we know something's going to happen for sure. It simply is not going to continue like it did, like it has. Just like Spindletop in Beaumont, Texas, changed the world by suddenly having this enormous reservoir of oil in the United States, and then discovering more and more and more oil, and this created this massive, massive global change. You know, before that, it wasn't like that. So massive changes can come very quickly, actually, on this planet. Very, very quickly. I mean, the industrialization has just happened in the last, like, 100 years or so. I mean, the heavy modern industry as we know it, it's the last 100 years, really. And it came about quite quickly. You just had this oil flowing, fossil fuels flowing everywhere, into every possible application. And so other changes can happen very quickly on this planet, actually. This notion that changes is slow and steady is ridiculous, completely ridiculous. Just look at this heavy industry, that the changes of fossil fuel, or the ready availability of massive amounts of fossil fuel, that didn't happen slowly. Didn't happen over millions of years. It happened like in a boom. Spindletop blew its top, and they found this massive, you know, reservoir of oil. And then they started realizing they could drill deep and find these deposits deeper, because before they were only finding deposits, shallow deposits. And everyone thought oil was only shallow, like 30, 60 feet or something. And nobody thought they could find any deep deposits at all. And then they found deep deposits, and that changed everything. Very quickly, very rapidly. So expect rapid change. Rapid destabilization. Very, very rapid destabilization now in today's world. And so it's important to look at the situation and simply say, I don't need the lessons of time at all. I am divine. I don't need the lessons of time. I am, and time is nothing. I am, and time is nowhere. And continue to refine your understanding of why we are trying to learn these lessons of time. We're trying because we're spirit, and we chose the idea of wanting to be prime creator, which means we have to change what we are, because we are one with the prime creator. Reality is one indivisible whole. If you try to change any part of it, you're trying to annihilate all of it. You're trying to change all of it. Since it's all one, you're trying to annihilate all of it. So if we're trying to be different than what we are, if we're trying to change what we are from spirit to prime creator, we are basically saying we have to suffer our annihilation. So since we cannot experience our annihilation, obviously if we're annihilated, there wouldn't be any experiencer. And reality can't be annihilated, so all we can do is imagine it. And the imagined effect would be total mental chaos. And then we realize we cannot abide in that as an experience. So we then imagine a past where we are training ourselves to be able to abide in it, a past of gradual loss. Gradual destabilization, bit by bit by bit by bit. You have existence, you have impermanence, the dance of Maya, the dance of duality, the dance of time. That's what we've imagined. We've imagined it all as a training exercise. So just see it that way. Just see it that way, and you'll find the entire situation will simplify, where you don't have all these questions coming at you from every possible direction, all these that's trying to psychologize everything. What do they mean by that? Who cares? Who cares what anybody means by anything? It's not important. If you know that this training exercise of time has no utility for you whatsoever, zero, who cares what anybody says or is doing, or what do they mean by that? It makes no difference whatsoever, other than just practically schlepping through your life, you know, but don't even worry about any of that. You know, if you stop reacting to people so much, they say something, it doesn't matter. Who cares? You know, training exercise, I don't need the lessons of time at all. Nobody does. And so you tend to just say, that's not important. I'm not going to struggle with it. I'm not going to try to figure it out. I already know what it's all about. So what else is there to figure out? Nothing. So your mind calms down and you don't have all this stuff going on in your mind like you know used to have when you're trying to figure everything out. When you're trying to learn the lessons of time so you can be free, you think, oh, I got to be enlightened, but I got to learn the lessons of time. No, just the opposite. You have to realize you don't need to learn the lessons of time. And then at some point, give a different purpose to all the staging. So the lesson's not even arising for you anymore. That's the ultimate. Ate too much pizza tonight. But sometimes that happens. You know, sometimes we eat too much pizza. That's okay. So, all right, well, don't worry about it. Don't try to psychologize it. Why did I eat a lot of pizza? You know, what made me cause it? Why would I eat some pizza? Is there some kind of unfulfilled need? Was someone bother me? Was I feeling like my self-esteem was low? Did I feel I need to forget it? Ate a lot of pizza because you felt like eating a lot of pizza, whatever, doesn't matter. Fact is that none of this is necessary. Has zero necessity to it. The past has no necessity to it. The past process is perfectly useless. Perfectly useless. All this is perfectly useless. And then we give a different purpose to it. A new purpose. Just say, okay, let's give it a new purpose so for the sake of continuity, I don't lose all the staging like that, and I can give a different purpose to it. So that is what we are working on, simply giving it a different purpose. So that's the next step, really, is to focus in on, okay, let's give it a new purpose. Let's give it a different purpose, that's all. Once we already know the simplicity of the situation, simply time is a training exercise, we don't need it. It doesn't do us any good whatsoever. Give it a new purpose. That's it. That simple. So, we'll go forward on that. We'll see what tomorrow has to do with a new purpose, and keep focusing on that, giving a new purpose, and try to stay away from any more complexities. No need for complexities, but there is need for speed, to go fast, because the training exercises continue in this world. They don't stop for anything. They don't stop because so we can't slow them down. Don't waste your time trying to slow them down, fighting against them. No, they're going to continue on. They're going to continue. What you need to do is say, I don't need them. That's a very different thing than trying to slow them down or, you know, no, I don't need them. Nobody needs them. Just abide in that presence of that certitude that I don't need them, nobody needs them. I'm feeling bliss. All right, very good. Time to get ready for tomorrow and to give a new purpose to process of time. That's it.